First off, my name's John Prettyman. I'm with the Public Affairs Office. So all the mailers you get, the website updates, any information that comes out about the project, that's coming from me. So you can put a face to all that. I'll just get into a quick overview here. So John Minetti, Senior Project Manager. He is just going to be opening up, give a kind of quick overview of the project, where we're at right now in the schedule. And then Paul Ziano, our real estate expert, he'll be following up John and get more of the details of where we're at with the real estate acquisitions, who's been impacted, and what are the next steps. And with that, I'll have John take over.
Okay, just in general about the project, and I almost spent I'm the senior project manager, so I come down to Isabella here quite a bit, and you'll see me again. Any general questions, they'll eventually come, probably end up with me, and I'll be glad to talk to anyone about the project. So again, briefly, the issues with the dam, the overtopping, the probability of a very large flood event, the earthquake, the fault zone, the seismic problem under the auxiliary dam, and then seepage, which is excessive for this dam. And those are the three things we're remediating it, and those are the benefits, of course. So again, it's a big, very large project, very high profile in the United States. So it'll be in three phases. The first phase, 2015-2016, is the relocation of Highway 178 to the east. The road will stay open, maybe some minor traffic stuff going on, but the road itself won't be closed. We'll also start to relocate from the hillside there, the Corps office and the Forest Service office, because that's where the new spillway is going to go. So that's phase one. Phase two is the main dam project. That's going to start in 2017. That's where we start to excavate the new spillway and start to build up the dams and the other ancillary work. Phase three is the rerouting of the Burrell Canal from right now, which goes through the auxiliary dam. It's going to be rerouted around the dam. That's one of the biggest problems with the auxiliary dam, is that conduit that goes through there. And that work is going to start in 2019. And the timeline, I believe there's a board here. And somebody asked a question. This is the timeline has not changed, and it's our job not to have it change. And we're, like I said, full speed ahead, and right now we have no indication that it'll change. That's why we're doing this real estate work early. That's usually one of the longest activities, and so that when we get to award the project in 2017, the real estate actions are all complete and that the property is available to us. That's all I have to say about the project, but if anybody has any other questions, I'll be here. I'm going to turn it over to Paul now. To really, the heart of this meeting is about real estate.
Thanks, John. Again, my name is Paul Ziano. I'm the chief of our Civil Works Acquisition and Management section within our real estate division for the Sacramento District with the Army Corps of Engineers. I'm just going to be discussing the processes of the acquisition of the parcels. This meeting's really geared for the impact of property owners. There's approximately 12 parcels that will be impacted. That includes the Lakeside Trailer Park, as well as some individual residences. There's an owner-occupied farmhouse that'll also be impacted by this project. So I just want to let you know. So if you are one of the impacted property owners, I don't know if you guys, you should have been already notified. We had appraisers come out a couple weeks ago.
The impacted properties pretty much run through this entire area right here, pretty much immediately downstream of the dam. We've got the Lakeside Trailer Park here. There's a owner-occupied residence, and there's a house up on a hill. There's some trailer vacation homes in this particular area that are occupied, as well as some land, unimproved land that is up in this area that we're going to need to acquire. Then the reason why we are acquiring these properties is because of the air quality model, as well as the noise and vibration issues associated with the construction equipment during the time frame that John Minetti was talking about. So we're talking about 2015 and beyond through 2017 when we actually do the construction for the dams and spillways contract. Okay.
Oh, and just a note too, in the handout, this map is up there, and the central red section you see there is the actual parcels and property that's planned to be acquired. all the other colors around there, that's the footprint of the project, just so you can see what areas are actually, there's going to be a lot of activity.
Yeah. Okay, just a couple of the steps in regards to the real estate process. If you have internet access under the Code of Federal Regulations 49, Part 24, it goes into specific details of the Uniform Relocation Assistance Program, as well as the acquisition policies. We have a booklet. We have two booklets. There is an acquisition booklet and there is a relocation. This is the relocation that's green. I think the acquisition is a bluer color. We ran out of those last night, but we can certainly provide, we'll definitely mail the acquisition booklets if any of the impacted property owners are here, so we can do that if you didn't get a copy from it last night. If you are one of the Trailer Park, Lakeside Trailer Park tenants, please pick up a copy if you have not received one of these. This goes into specific details, basically in regards to the CFR Part 24, so it goes into really good details. Tons of information here, please read through it. So we'll answer quite a few of your questions, okay? Okay, so back in December of 2012, we had the Dam Safety Modification Report, the DSMR, as maybe some of you know about it. That was approved in December of 2012. With that document, we identified the 12 parcels that were going to be impacted by the project. So at that time, that's when the 12 parcels were impacted based on the air quality model and the noise and vibration issues that were stated in the environmental impact study. What we've done so far is we've contacted the 12 parcel owners and notified them that, like I just said before, that they were going to have appraisers take a look at their property and do the appraisals. There's this kind of a multi-step process in regards to acquiring properties. And the first step, obviously, is to appraise the value of the property. That will give us the fair market value of that property. And that's what we use to, in our offer to sell, I'll go into that a little bit more detail here, that will send that package to the landowners to let them know what we feel, U.S. government feels, is a fair market value of your property, okay? After we submit the offer to sell, which is roughly in the fall of 2014, the appraisals, we're gonna get those appraisers out as soon as we possibly can. I've got summer of 2014. That's probably the end. We have 12, like I said, 12 appraisals that we have to go through. So there's quite a bit of work that we need to do. The trailer park, which because it has tenants associated with that, have to be relocated, that takes time. So that appraisal is the first priority of the properties that needs to be completed as soon as possible. The other one is the other owner-occupied residence. That's the second one that's the highest priority because they actually occupy that residence, and so they also need to be relocated as well, okay? So, and then others will follow after that. The offer to sell is a package, about a 4-page document. If you are one of the landowners, one of the impacted 12 parcels, you will receive one of these offers to sell. Please read through it completely. There will also be a cover letter as well that will inform you of all the associated details of kind of the process, what needs to happen. As soon as you receive that offer to sell, probably within the next couple of days after that, because we're going to send it certified mail. We'll have a notice that you had actually received it. We'll get in contact with you and set up a face-to-face meeting, probably within 2 weeks. We want to sit down with you and kind of go over the entire offer to sell as well as the appraisal itself. Let me go back a little bit too. And the appraisal is there's certain federal standards. They call it the Yellow Book. And it has to meet certain requirements, federal standards, in order to appraise everybody's property. And we can go into more specific detail later, but I just want to kind of give you a general overview. When we do the face-to-face meetings, we're going to go through the entire appraisal, how we came up with these values, the fair market value. Okay. One thing I want to bring up too is, once we get the offer to sell, we're probably looking at, for the most part, roughly in the June timeframe, is we're really pushing to get our appraisers out for the Lakeside Trailer Park as well as for the owner-occupied residence. The tenants at the Lakeside Trailer Park as well as at the owner-occupied residence are going to be contacted by my relocation specialist probably in the very beginning of June to start working with those residences in regards to their relocation capability, okay? We're going to do face-to-face interviews. We're going to be down here working with you, understanding your financial circumstance. Like I said, everybody's in a certain case-by-case basis. Everybody's going to be different. So we want to work with you in regards to finding you in a new location, okay? So that's really important. Another really important thing is if you're a Lakeside Trailer Park tenant, please do not move at this point in time. There's no need, it's not necessary to move, okay? Stay where you are, please, okay? So that's really important. The next step in regards to the offers to sell, once you do receive the copy, like I said, please read through it. We're gonna have interviews with each one of the impacted parcel owners. We'll go through it. We'll have the meeting, the face-to-face meeting, approximately 2 weeks. We'll go through the negotiations even after those 2 weeks. You'll get back to us if you feel that the fair market value is appropriate or it's not. And we need a lot of feedback from you and why and justification why you feel it's not or maybe it is. And as soon as we get that copy, the offer to sell executed, which I mean by signing, the government will sign it and then we'll send it off to our escrow company for escrow. It'll close through escrow and then obviously within 30 to 45 days, depending upon the length of the escrow, you'll receive a check for the value of your property. An important fact that I want to make sure everybody is aware is your title. All encumbrances on the title, it's up to the landowner to resolve. So I'm talking about liens, restrictions on your property that you may have. It is up to the property owner to clear those title issues. Now, the Army Corps of Engineers can certainly assist you, but it is up to the property owner to clear those issues, okay? So that's important too. We will definitely work with you in dealing with those situations as well, okay? Relocations, assistance. I talked a little bit, it says initial meeting July. It's gonna happen in June, like I said. We wanna really start working with the Lakeside Trailer Park tenants as well as the owner-occupied residents of the farmhouse. So that's really important to identify everybody's circumstances and where we're all at. We also need to find out, in regards to other residences in the area, if there's vacancies and how we can move you to those new places. Okay? So that's really important. We, again, during those interviews, will determine your financial capability, understand, where you're at, what we can do, how we can move you to these new locations. So that's really important. Replacement of housing. If you own your trailer park, if you own your trailer, that's a certain circumstance that we need to understand. If you do, if you're just renters, that's another circumstance. So everybody's, like I said, it's all on a case-by-case basis. That needs to all be discussed during our face-to-face interviews. That's really important. If you have pets, if you have children, that all comes into play in regards to finding you a new location. So please be up front and forward with my specialist because that's really important information that we need to know about. Okay. And then obviously, placement to your new place. So, there's definitely an opportunity right now for you to look at different locations. If you see something out there, just keep an eye out on it that you may like of another trailer park in the area that may have vacancies. Definitely keep it in mind. So when we do the face-to-face interviews, you can certainly bring that up during those interviews, okay? So that's important. We talked about the title of property, to clear all the encumbrances for all the landowners that are gonna be impacted. That's really important. Again, when we meet with you, after 2 weeks after we receive the offer to sell, we'll definitely bring those issues up. If there are any, there may not be any. And so that would be great news. Okay. After escrow closes, again, the landowner will receive their their check, their compensation check, their fair market value of the property, okay, after escrow closes. So that's how that kind of works. It's really, really close to transactions for the most part in regards to a residential home. The process is very similar. I want to let everybody know too, on the end part of this slide, it talks about on where you can find some information about the project. Here's the website. So if you have any interest in that, please go ahead and seek that website out. John, you want to advance it on the question?
No, I don't need it.
Kind of went over this, when I will know if my property is impacted. Everybody who's been impacted on the 12 parcel, there was letters that went out in regards to the appraisers going to be appraising your the value of your property. So that was sent out probably about 3 weeks ago, roughly. So those owners have already been identified. So if you receive one of those letters, an appraiser is going to be out there. That's one of your informal letters of being notified. There'll be others as well, like I talked about, that the offer to sell. That will also be another, as well as this public meeting being notified of the impacts of those 12 parcels, as well as the Lakeside Trailer Park tenants. Again, the official contact Lakeside Trailer Park tenants. Again, this is the announcement. We're letting you know in regards to, what's going on. We're going to have interviews again in the very beginning of June to maybe middle of June. So just, be patient with us. We're going to be interviewing every single one of the Lakeside Trailer Park tenants. So just be aware, and we're going to be definitely talking with you. And then I don't know if you've heard some of these things going around. Government would buy me out 45% above the fair market value. I'm curious, had anybody heard that? No? Okay. I just want to let everyone know that's completely incorrect. I mean, we talked about there is some leeway back and forth, but certainly it's not going to be 45% above the fair market value. Okay, so I just want to kind of shut that down. Okay. That's the end of the presentation. If there's any other additional questions, I can definitely field them.